Right, the biggest clincher that India today has accessed is the CCTV footage, the cameras that rolled while the accused Sanjay Roy walked into this very hospital that I'm standing at, RG Kar Medical College and Hospital. Sanjay Roy has walked in straight in the wee hours of the morning, enters the hospital looking for his heart. He manages to get into the seminar hall, and that's what's captured on the CCTV cameras. India Today has that footage here. We're playing out for you for the first time. Clinching evidence that's on record. Sanjay Roy can be seen in the visual on the night of 9th August in RG Kar Hospital. We're looking at the CCTV footage that eventually led to his arrest. In the footage, he can be seen wearing jeans and a t-shirt. Sanjay Roy had a helmet in his hand. His helmet is also used by the Kolkata police officials, and that shows the proximity that Sanjay Roy had with the Kolkata police officials. In fact, we know very well that he slept in the police barracks, which is very close to the Sanjay Kar Hospital, the RG Kar Hospital. Sanjay worked with the police on many levels. He was called Daku Babu, which means a man, an agent of the police, basically to help them with some of the activities. A lot of times he was carrying out dubious activities. This man, knowing very well the layout of the RG Kar Hospital, walks in, and that's the footage that we have on the CCTV cameras that we've accessed. It shows Sanjay Roy holding a helmet in his hand while he walks in. He walks into the RG Kar Hospital precisely at 4:03 a.m. on the 9th of August. The helmet, as we know, is used by the Kolkata police as well. So the brazenness with which he manages to walk in shows that he's basically flexing his influence that he has with not just the police, but also with some of the hospital authorities. We also know that there was a Bluetooth that eventually helped link him in this case, that he dropped on the ground when he was trying to hurry out right after he walked in, realized there was a CCTV camera after carrying out the rape and murder. And then when he was trying to hurry out, his Bluetooth fell off the ground, and that's what eventually led to his arrest. For the first time, the entire sequence caught right here on India Today.
আর একটা হলো যে পলিগ্রাফ টেস্টে তার সম্মতির সময়ও আমি উপস্থিত ছিলাম এবং তার সম্মতি সে দিয়েছে টেস্টের ব্যাপারে সবকিছু আমরা তাকে বুঝিয়ে বলে আমি তাকে বুঝিয়ে বলেছি এবং সে রাজি হয়েছে কেন সে রাজি হয়েছে না সে বলছে যে আমার উপরে যে চাপটা আছে যে আমি করেছি আমি চাইছি সত্য সামনে আসুক আর আমি এই কেসে ইনভলভ নই সেই জন্য সে চাইছে যত রকম টেস্টই হোক সেটা সে সহযোগিতা করে আসল আসামি অবধি সে আমাদের পৌঁছতে সাহায্য করবে
All right. Well, if before I get to Arvind Oja, who's brought us that exclusive CCTV footage, here's a quick look at the protest that continues exactly at 6:04 p.m., 2 weeks right after the rape and murder of the young trainee doctor. We're looking at the agitation gaining momentum outside the college premises. These are relentless protests. Remember, these are people who work at the RG Kar Hospital. So they are very familiar with the activities within the hospital and are mighty frustrated, angry. And that is coming out here visible that the hospital authorities did not handle the case as per protocols. They felt that there was a lot of loose ends which should have been plugged in right when the crime surfaced at this hospital. That wasn't done. They believe this was done only to protect some of the powerful people in the picture who could be still hiding. Let me cut across to Arvind Oja joining us for more on that. Arvind, ye CCTV footage aapne jo hame exclusively diya hai, jo CBI ke haath mein bhi hai, ye bahut bada lead hoga CBI ke liye, kyunki वो आदमी संजय रॉय यही रास्ते से जहां पर मैं खड़ी हूं इसी रास्ते से अंदर गया जो वहां पर गेट है वो गेट के अंदर 4 बजे सुबह रात को अंदर जाके फिर वो थर्ड फ्लोर ऊपर जो सेमिनार हॉल है उसके अंदर घुस गया क्या उसको पता था कि वो लड़की वहां पर थी या वो एक शिकार ढूंढने में निकला था
बिल्कुल वो शिकार ढूंढने निकला था लेकिन उसके पहले मैं बता दूं कि इंडिया टुडे पर ये मेगा एक्सक्लूसिव न्यूज ब्रेक है ये जो सीसीटीवी सिर्फ सीसीटीवी नहीं है बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है एविडेंस के तौर पर और जो ये सीसीटीवी है ये इंडिया टुडे ने निकाला है और आपको ये भी बता दूं कि इंडिया टुडे की टीम ने उस अस्पताल का 9 अगस्त का पूरा सीसीटीवी फुटेज भी देखा है जिसमें जो संजय रॉय है वो दिखाई दे रहा है हमारे साथ हमारी कलीग श्रेया है सबसे पहले मैं आपको ये दिखाता हूँ और इसके जरिए अपने जो व्यूवर्स हैं उनको जरा एक्सप्लेन करता हूँ ये आप देखिए ये संजय रॉय है कॉर्नर में खड़ा हुआ दिखाई दे रहा है, हाथ में इसके हेलमेट आपको दिखाई दे रहा होगा, और यहाँ पर ब्लूटूथ, ये अगर ब्लैक कलर का, चूंकि ये हम बताएं ये फेस हमने इसलिए ब्लर किया हुआ है चूंकि ये केस अभी कोर्ट में जाएगा और इसकी TIP होगी, इसकी पहचान की जाएगी, इस वजह से ये हमने ब्लर किया। ये जो संजय है ये इस साइड सामने की तरफ देख रहा है और हर तरफ अपना मुंह कर रहा है, और ये इस साइड मुड़ता है, ये आगे की तरफ सेमिनार हॉल है जहां पर जो विक्टिम है वो सोई हुई थी। तो ये अपने आप में फर्स्ट टाइम 9 अगस्त के बाद फर्स्ट टाइम ये इंडिया टुडे, चूंकि अलग अलग थ्योरी चल रही थी, ये हम एस्टैब्लिश कर रहे हैं कि जो संजय रॉय है वो आजकल हॉस्पिटल में सेमिनार हॉल के आसपास 4 बजे के आसपास मौजूद था, और 4 बजे से 4:30 बजे के बीच जो फॉरेंसिक एग्जामिनेशन हुआ है बॉडी का, उससे एस्टैब्लिश होता है कि खाना खाने के 4 घंटे बाद जो पीड़िता है उसकी मौत हो गई थी। हमारे साथ कलीग जो हमारी है श्रेया, श्रेया ये जो CCTV फुटेज है ये कितना इम्पोर्टेंट है इस केस में?
But you know the CCTV footage is extremely crucial because if we closely look at it, there is a Bluetooth headset which can be seen around the shoulder of Sanjay Roy. Now this very Bluetooth headset is seen at 4:03 a.m. when he's entering. This footage is when he's entering the third floor of the RG Kar hospital. Now clearly this is also the floor where the seminar room is, where the crime scene took place. When he's again captured in the CCTV, which is at 4:32 a.m., this Bluetooth headset was missing. Now, where was this Bluetooth headset found? It was found at the crime scene. When Sanjay Roy was arrested, this Bluetooth headset was already in a sealed pack as an exhibit by the forensic team. It automatically matched, is why Sanjay Roy was looked at as the prime suspect and the only suspect in the rape and accused case.
और हम ये भी बताना चाहते हैं इंडिया टुडे के अपने व्यूवर्स को कि जो जो थर्ड फ्लोर का सेमिनार हॉल है उसके आसपास ये एक सेमिनार हॉल के आसपास सामने की तरफ कोई CCTV नहीं है, लेकिन उस तरफ जो मूवमेंट होगी थर्ड फ्लोर पे ये CCTV कैमरा सभी को कैप्चर कर रहा था। और इसमें अगर आप ये देखिए तो संजय का आप जेस्चर पोस्चर देखिए, वो हर कमरे की तलाशी ले रहा था। मैंने खुद ने वो CCTV फुटेज देखा, जब वो यहां आता है तो अगर आप देखिए फ्रंट साइड देख रहा है, उसके बाद जिधर उसको लगता है कोई स्कोप है, जैसा आपने शुरू में क्वेश्चन पूछा कि क्या वो शिकार की तलाश में था, जी हाँ, कम से कम जो मैंने CCTV फुटेज देखा और जो इंडिया टुडे ने फर्स्ट टाइम एक्सेस किया है उससे ये साफ होता है कि वो किसी शिकार की तलाश में था। और उसके बाद ये जो रास्ता जाता है, ये जो कॉरिडोर है, ये सेमिनार हॉल की तरफ जाता है जहां पर विक्टिम थी। उसके बाद जो संजय रॉय है वो अलग अलग कमरे को दरवाजे खोलता है, उसके बाद सेमिनार हॉल में जब उसे पता चलता है कि विक्टिम उसके अंदर है, फिर वो जाता है और जो इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर है उसने इंडिया टुडे को बताया है कि सबसे पहले चूंकि जो विक्टिम थी वो सो रही थी, हाफ अनकॉन्शियस थी, उसके बाद सीधा जाकर जो संजय रॉय है वो उसका इस तरीके से मुंह दबाता है, गला दबाता है, उसके बाद जब वो थोड़ा विरोध करती है उसके बाद उसका पूरी तरह से गला दबाता है, उसके बाद वो रेप करता है, उसके बाद मर्डर करता है और उसके बाद वहां से चला जाता है। लेकिन अब ये हम बता रहे हैं ये CCTV क्यों इंपॉर्टेंट है, जब वो यहां से जाता है तब वो ब्लूटूथ उसके गले में है, लेकिन जब इसी कॉरिडोर से वो बाहर आता है तो वो ब्लूटूथ मिसिंग होता है। और यही जो कोलकाता पुलिस या एजेंसीज है उनके पास एक बड़ा एविडेंस लगता है, और वो ब्लूटूथ कहीं और से नहीं, वो जो विक्टिम है उसकी बॉडी के पास से एजेंसी ने रिकवर किया। इस वजह से जो संजय रॉय है वो प्राइम सस्पेक्ट है और अक्यूज्ड है इस रेप एंड मर्डर केस का।
जी बिल्कुल, जो आप कह रहे हो जो ब्लूटूथ, दैट्स लेट मी रिमाइंड आवर व्यूअर्स दैट ब्लूटूथ एक्टेड एज द मेन एविडेंस टू नैब संजय रॉय, बिकॉज अ मैन हु वॉक्स इन टू द हॉस्पिटल विद सच ब्रेजननेस थिंकिंग ही इज नेवर गोइंग टू बी कॉट, क्लियरली मस्ट हैव बीन इन एन इनेबिलिटेड स्टेट, ही वाज ड्रंक वी हियर, ही गेट्स इन टू द सेमिनार हॉल लुकिंग फॉर हिज, बेसिकली ही लुक्स फॉर हिज हंट, ही चेक्स एवरी रूम लीडिंग अप टू दैट सेमिनार हॉल, and then finally finds the girl alone inside the seminar hall and then attempts the rape and murder, goes through with it, not attempts, he goes through with the rape and murder, and then comes out and that CCTV footage is clearly showing him walking out with the Bluetooth set with him, that's clearly shown around his shoulder. But when he sees the CCTV footage, he sort of gets rattled and then goes back into the seminar hall hoping to find another alternative route to exit, but then realizes there's no other way out. So then he comes back in a complete rush and then runs out towards the gate where I'm at. This is exactly the way he's run out. So that's basically the entrance of RG Car Hospital, and he's come down and rushes out of the main gate here. So a bit of that has been captured on the CCTV cameras, and that rush, the fact that he got rattled looking at the CCTV cameras itself, because of that rush, he dropped the Bluetooth in the seminar hall, and that's what eventually led when the cops called many people who they were suspicious of, and based on the CCTV cameras, they also saw Sanjay Roy in the footage, they called them, and that Bluetooth that the cops had with them automatically connected to his phone. That was the biggest giveaway in this case. Now I'm going to take you through, while Shreya and Arvind Oja stays with us, I'm going to take you through a quick look on what panned out on the night of that murder, basically the night before that. This girl, the young doctor, trainee doctor, was basically with four other doctors, after 36 hours of duty. They were right there on the third floor of the seminar hall. In fact, they had just ordered their dinner. They finished their dinner. We understand the victim and two first-year PG doctors were sitting together enjoying the Olympic match. At that point, we understand that even Neeraj Chopra's game was going on. Neeraj Chopra clinched a silver Olympic medal. She cheered for Neeraj Chopra. So all of this happened. I'm taking you through the timeline. After dinner, they watched a little bit of that Olympic match. Then two of the doctors claimed that they decided to sleep in the seminar hall. So the girl, along with one of the other doctors, both decided to sleep at the seminar hall together. But after a little while, one of the doctors decided that she wanted to get to another room. She had some work that she had to wake up for in the middle, and she moved out. Now, we see here that the house staff went to the third floor, and that's also captured in the CCTV cameras. I'm specifically bringing you these details because these are the four people, three other doctors and one other staff member who's also now under suspicion of the CBI. Remember, the CBI has also grilled these four trainee doctors, three trainee doctors and one staff member. They've been called in, they've been questioned, and they're also going to be going through a polygraph test. So this is very important as I read you, bring you the sequence of events here. These are the four people who saw that victim last. They saw her last and left her at the seminar hall before they dispersed. And we know that one of the house staff claims that they couldn't hear anything because there was a lot of questions about how could nobody hear her scream, yell, call for help. According to these doctors, young doctors, they say the seminar hall is soundproof, and therefore they couldn't hear her scream at all, even if she did. But we also know that this man is a trained boxer. He must have gagged her to such an extent, smothered her, throttled her, where she may not have had the opportunity to scream extensively. How soon did he actually murder her before raping her, or murder her after raping her? We're still, of course, yet to establish the actual sequence of events on that front. But it's quite clear that Sanjay Roy was a lone person who walked into this very gate of the RG Car Hospital, manages his way all the way to the third floor on his own, looking for his hunt. And unfortunately, there was Abhaya sleeping at the seminar hall. And then finally, in the next morning, the lifeless body, mutilated, of Abhaya was found in that seminar hall. And what's very disappointing is that the same hospital, which was once reputed, I would say once reputed because it's right now got a shadow of taint for not following up with the investigation as per protocols, the once reputed hospital tried at the helm was Sandeep Ghosh, the ex-principal, tried all that they can to play down this case and initially made it look like this was a case of suicide. First they said the daughter was ill to the parents, and then second phone call goes to the parents where they claim she's committed suicide. The parents rush and come to the hospital, and they were not allowed to see her body for nearly 3 hours, after which they saw her body and realized this was rape and murder. Arvind Oja and Shreya still with us. A quick word from Arvind on that. Arvind, जो संजय रॉय है, जो उन्होंने बयान दिया है सीबीआई को भी और कोलकाता पुलिस को भी, हाँ मैंने ही किया है, मुझे फांसी लगा दो, कोई भी उसमें एक परसेंट का गिल्ट नहीं है या वो अपोलोजेटिक नहीं है, उसको कोई मतलब फिकर नहीं है कि ऐसा हुआ है. वो बोल रहा है कि हाँ मैंने किया है, मुझे फांसी लगा दो. सीबीआई कह रही है इनका एनिमल इंस्टिंक्ट है, ये एक सेक्सुअल पर्वर्ट है जो एक हैबिटुअल ऑफेंडर हो भी सकता है. मेरा आपको साफ क्वेश्चन है, क्या ऐसा हो सकता है ये किसी और के साथ भी किया है उन्होंने पहले भी?
नहीं, ये तो इन्वेस्टिगेशन के बाद पता चलेगा नवीला, अभी वो सीबीआई की कस्टडी में है। लेकिन एक बात क्लियर है कि जो एविडेंस मिले हैं उससे ये पता चलता है कि उस रात ये किसी न किसी इंसिडेंट को अंजाम जरूर देता। इस तरह के एविडेंस एजेंसीज को मिले हैं। इंडिया टुडे की कोशिश है कि सोर्सेस के हवाले से हम वो डिटेल एक्सेस करें, नंबर एक। नंबर दो, ये जो सीसीटीवी फुटेज है उसके अराउंड में, उसमें काफी चीजें क्लियर हैं। जो उसका जेस्चर पोस्चर है वो काफी कुछ क्लियरिटी देता है। अगर कोई इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर है वो सीसीटीवी फुटेज को देखेगा तो उसमें काफी कुछ क्लियरिटी उसको आ जाएगी। जहां तक रही बात इसके साइकोलॉजी की, उसका बिल्कुल साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्ट कराया सीबीआई ने, उसमें भी काफी कुछ चीजें जानकारी मिली है। लेकिन जहां तक रही बात जब इसको अरेस्ट किया गया तो यह बात सामने आई, सबसे पहले तो उसने बोला कि मुझे फांसी दे दो। लेकिन यह फर्स्ट टाइम था जब इसने बोला कि फांसी दे दो। नेक्स्ट डे इसको कोई अफसोस नहीं था। इसके चेहरे पर खुद इंडिया टुडे की टीम ने उस ऑफिसर से बातचीत की जिसने संजय रॉय को इंट्रोगेट किया। उसने ये कहा कि पहले दिन जब वो आता है तो वो ये बोलता है कि उसे फांसी दे दो। लेकिन सेकेंड डे से उसको कोई अफसोस नहीं था, कोई चेहरे पर किसी तरह का कोई रिएक्शन नहीं था, कोई अफसोस नहीं था उसको। तो ये जो फांसी दे दो ये फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट है, चूंकि इसे लगा नहीं था कि ये अरेस्ट होगा। लेकिन जब इसे अरेस्ट होता है तो फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में जरूर बोलता है कि मुझे फांसी दे दो। लेकिन सेकेंड डे थर्ड डे जब इंटरोगेशन होती है तो इसके चेहरे पर किसी तरह का कोई हाव भाव नहीं, कोई अफसोस नहीं, कोई पछतावा नहीं कि इसने इतने बड़े इंसिडेंट को अंजाम दिया, ये इंसिडेंट करता है। उसके बाद उसी कोलकाता के 4th बटालियन में चला जाता है। हम एक बार श्रेया को कहेंगे कि वो फिर जो इमेज है, ऑल्दो हम ये दिखा रहे हैं लेकिन हम ये एक्सप्लेन करके दिखाना चाहते हैं कि चूंकि 9 अगस्त को इंसिडेंट हुआ उसके बाद से अलग अलग जो
अरविंद हम वापस आएंगे आपके पास। श्रेया, आई विल कम बैक टू यू ऑन दैट, श्योरली ऑन दैट, whether दिस मैन हियर संजय रॉय इज अ हैबिचुअल ऑफेंडर एंड गोइंग बाय हिज पास्ट एंड द काइंड ऑफ क्लाउट ही होल्ड्स विद द पुलिस, द ब्रेजननेस विद व्हिच ही वॉक्ड इनटू द हॉस्पिटल, ही रियली फेल्ट दैट ही वाज इनविंसिबल, दैट ही कुड पुल ऑफ अ क्राइम एंड रियली गेट अवे विद इट। माय क्वेश्चन इज, कुड दिस man be a habitual offender? I'm going to take you through, before I get your answer on that, I'm going to take our viewers through exactly what the CBI probe has found through the psychoanalytic test that's been done of this very man, Sanjay Roy. The prime accused has been described by the CBI here as a man who's a sexual pervert with animal instincts. Now, after his police custody ended today, the court has sent him to 14 days judicial custody. Let's take you through this report, what the CBI has found of this man as they profile him.
The CBI investigation into the horrific rape and murder of a trainee doctor at Kolkata's RG Corps Medical College is unearthing disturbing details. Sources say the psychoanalytic profiling of suspect Sanjay Roy revealed that he has animal-like instincts. As per sources, he is a pervert, severely addicted to pornography. What's even more shocking is his alleged lack of remorse. Sources say during the interrogation, he allegedly recounted the entire crime without any hesitation. The CBI sources say the evidence collected so far points towards Roy's involvement. At 4:03 a.m. on August 9, Roy allegedly entered the seminar hall where the victim was sleeping. At around 4:40 a.m., the accused exited the seminar hall after allegedly committing the rape and murder. Sources say the estimated time of death is between 4:15 a.m. and 4:40 a.m. The victim was attacked when she was resting in the hospital seminar hall during her 36-hour shift. As per the post-mortem report, the trainee doctor was raped, brutally beaten, and ultimately strangled and smothered to death. Sanjay Roy was arrested a day after the crime. After CCTV footage captured him entering the seminar hall at the estimated time of the crime, his Bluetooth headphones were found near the scene.
আমরাই ধৈর্য হারাচ্ছি প্রতিদিন, 14 দিন হয়ে গেল কোনো রেজাল্ট পাইনি, স্বাভাবিক ব্যাপার। বলতে চাইছি সবাই একটু তৎপর হয়ে কাজটা করুক এবং সিবিআই এর উপর যে মানুষের যে আস্থা আছে সেই আস্থা রেখেই কাজটা, আমরাও আস্থা রেখেছি যখন সেই আস্থা রেখে এত বড় ঘটনা তদন্ত করে কিছু একটা কুল কিনারা করুক। একটা কথা বলছি, আবারই সেই ছাত্ররা যে আন্দোলন করছে সেই আন্দোলনের পাশে আমরা আছি, প্রয়োজন হলে এরপরে আমরাও গিয়ে ওদের সঙ্গে যোগ দেব, এটাই পর্যন্ত বলতে পারি। কারণ আমরা বিচার চাই, বিষয়টাকে তো প্রথম থেকেই একটা মানে গুলিয়ে দেওয়ার চেষ্টা হচ্ছে আর কি। হ্যাঁ, গুলিয়ে দেওয়ার চেষ্টা হচ্ছে, মেইন হচ্ছে বিষয়টাকে গুলিয়ে দেওয়ার চেষ্টা হচ্ছে।
Sources in the CBI tell India Today the DNA evidence is also a match for Sanjay Roy. Parents of Abhaya are unhappy with the pace of investigation and suspect a deeper conspiracy behind the crime.
হ্যাঁ, সেটা তো আমরা আস্থা হারাচ্ছি, আমরা একটা দিন যাচ্ছে আর আস্থা
একটা দিন আমাদের এখন এক বছরের থেকেও বেশি।
আমাদের আমরা একমাত্র মেয়েকে হারিয়েছি এবং যেখানে সে স্বপ্ন পূরণ করতে গেছিল সেখানেই তার সমস্ত স্বপ্ন শেষ হয়ে গেছে।
সঞ্জয় রয় ওয়াজ সেন্ট টু 14 ডে জুডিশিয়াল কাস্টডি অন ফ্রাইডে উইথ মুনিশ পান্ডে ইন দিল্লি, শ্রেয়া চ্যাটার্জি, নবিলা জামাল ইন কলকাতা। ব্যুরো রিপোর্ট, ইন্ডিয়া টুডে।
Right, let me now quickly take you through a little on the ex-principal Sandeep Ghosh. In the latest, we have, as per what India Today has accessed, a letter written by Mamata Banerjee wishing Sandeep Ghosh, the ex-principal of RJD Car, a very happy birthday. Now, why this holds huge significance is considering our reporters here, our team of reporters of India Today in West Bengal tell us that this is a kind of courtesy that Mamata Banerjee awards to just a select few people. Those who have access to the government higher-ups, those who the government believes are people of stature. In their view, people who have worked very closely with the government, who are loyal to the government, etc., are the ones who are awarded this gesture of a personalized birthday wish. And that's precisely what we see of Mamata Banerjee, who sent out a happy birthday letter to Sandeep Ghosh in 2022, just a year after he took over as the principal of RJ Carr Medical College and Hospital. I'm going to take you through exactly what this letter reads. The letter that's dated June 2022, that's addressed to Professor Ghosh, reads, and I quote, "Please accept my heartiest greetings and best wishes on your birthday. May you fulfill all your dreams and may your life be blessed with more happiness, success and good health in the days ahead. I also wish your family members all the very best." This formal birthday wish that's dated June 2022 was sent a year after he took over as a principal here. He took over in 2021, and a quick understanding, RJ Carr Hospital principal, in fact, studied in the same hospital and passed out. He graduated right from here. This is his alma mater. And he comes back as a principal years after he had passed out. So for him, it's certainly a prestigious position to be in. And we understand that he worked extensively for the TMC government to handle the state-run government hospital and had a great rapport with the higher-ups of the TMC. I'm going to cut across to Indrajit joining us live. Indrajit, this letter here, as one can trivialize it, saying this is just a happy birthday wish, and Mamata Banerjee does that to many of the government employees. You don't have to read too much into it. Why this is important here is because this man was actually let go scot-free. He wasn't called in for questioning right after the murder and rape came to light here. He in fact resigned on moral grounds because he himself was embarrassed to continue because this happened under his watch. But shockingly, the West Bengal government tried to placate him and in a few hours' time made him the principal of another reputed institution here in West Bengal. Questions on whether there was someone much more influential who's trying to shield him for reasons still unknown.
Well, Nabila, you know, when the stuff that you've just said and what is there in public domain, the fact that this the principal initially refused to resign, then when he tendered his public resignation, immediately soon after he was reinstated by the West Bengal government to another prestigious hospital as the principal. And then due to public pressure, due to the pressure of students who were protesting, he could not join. And then it was the intervention of the Calcutta High Court that he was sent on leave. And no posting has been given to Dr. Sandeep Ghosh, and he is currently under the scanner of the CBI. For 7 consecutive days, he has been questioned, and the CBI also seeks to conduct a polygraph test on him. He does hold key to the investigation, specifically because of the fact that this heinous crime has taken place under his watch as the principal of Arjikar Medical College Hospital. And therefore, he is an influential person, that goes without saying, because despite his resignation, the government didn't want to let him go, and he was moved to another college as the principal. It was only after public pressure that, he was removed. And it was only after the intervention of the court. In this backdrop, in all these details that have emerged now over the past close to 2 weeks now, this letter that was written, that was signed and, sent as a goodwill gesture from the Chief Minister's office to Sandeep Ghosh in 2022. In 2021, Sandeep Ghosh had actually taken over as the principal of Arjikar Medical College Hospital. In this backdrop, it is significant. This is not to say that a chief minister or the chief minister's office here is complicit or this shows as an evidence. No, it doesn't. But it does show how influential Dr. Sandeep Ghosh is. Yes, the chief minister's office does send out such goodwill gesture letters, wishing people on their birthdays and other occasions. Several people, eminent personalities across West Bengal, across various sectors, such letters are sent to them from the chief minister. This is a goodwill gesture. One may not read much into it. However, in the backdrop of what's happening at Arjikar, one thing that only gets proved from this letter is that how influential Sandeep Ghosh is, because not everyone, at least not, the 10 crore Janta of West Bengal gets such letters from the chief minister. Everyone doesn't get a letter. It is only those who are high, mighty, influential, eminent personalities in the state who are given such, letters from the chief minister's office as a goodwill gesture. And this does prove that Dr. Sandeep Ghosh was placed well in the rank and he had, some sort of a connection and access to the higher-ups within the Trinamool Congress, plain and simple.
What do you want? What do you want?
Okay. All right. Thanks very much, Indrajit. I'm going to quickly cut across to this special report that India Today has put together, showing how the noose is really tightened now on the ex-principal Sandeep Ghosh. Because under his watch, the murder at the Arjikar, rape and murder has happened. The way the man brutalized her and manages to walk in and walk out without any fear shows the kind of security lapses and how doctors here clearly weren't safe. Now, the CBI is currently grilling Ghosh for the eighth consecutive time. CBI is set to carry out a polygraph test of this very principle as well. They're going to try and see if there are some inconsistencies in the statements that he's given to the CBI so far. Taking you through this report, let's have a look.
The principal of Arjikar Hospital till a few days ago, now under scanner after Abhya rape and murder case. Noose is tightening around former principal Dr. Sandeep Ghosh. The CBI grilled Ghosh for the eighth time straight on Friday. India Today has accessed the CBI's line of questioning. Ghosh was asked to specify what he did after getting the news of the death of the doctor. He was asked why he made the parents wait for almost 3 hours before they could see their daughter's body. Ghosh was also asked about the renovation on hospital premises and if he's ever interacted with accused Sanjay Roy directly. Victim's parents also pointed fingers at Ghosh, claiming their daughter was afraid of him.
Principal Sandeep Ghosh, take tar somporke kichu shunechen ki mer mukhe?
Na
kono kichu na eta shunechi ami shunechi me to amake sob kichu bolto uni naki taka niye fail koriye den ebong me baba ke bolto bapi ami je okhane achi eta kauke bolbe na kauke bhorti koriye dite ami parbo na tale amake fail koriye debe egulo me bolechi
samasya toiri hoto college shei jonno eto chape thakto ar ki ei sob to chap chilo.
The CBI is set to conduct polygraphy test on multiple suspects. Ghosh will undergo lie detector test because of his alleged inconsistent statements. Two doctors, because their fingerprints were found in seminar hall. One housekeeping staff, because he was seen in the CCTV. And an intern, because he spoke with the victim before she went for rest. The role of two doctors, a housekeeping staff and an intern, is also under lens. Four of them and the victim were on 36-hour duty the night the murder took place. At around midnight, the victim and two PGT doctors had dinner together. Between 1:30 a.m. and 2 a.m., Abhaya and two doctors spent time in seminar hall on the third floor and watched Olympics javelin final of Neeraj Chopra. After the match, the two first-year PG doctors went to the room near seminar hall where sleeping tests are conducted. Around 2:45 a.m., the housekeeping staff went to the third floor where his movement was captured on CCTV. The intern was in the room designated to him. All four of them claimed they could not hear anything since seminar room is soundproof. At 9:15 a.m., first-year PG doctors went to call the victim for rounds and found her motionless body. The hospital authorities then informed the cops. Sources within the CBI also revealed significant lapses on the part of the hospital's former principal, Dr. Sandeep Ghosh, who failed to protect the crime scene and delayed filing the FIR.
এগারোটার সময় জানো নাই বা কেন হয়েছিল সেটাই তো বুঝতে পারছি না। চারটের সময় আমাদের আমার মেয়েদেরকে দেখতে দেওয়া হয়েছে, এতক্ষণ ধরে আমাদের ওখানে নিয়ে বসিয়ে রাখার কি যুক্তি ছিল তারাই জানেন। কিন্তু কর্তৃপক্ষ আমাদের সঙ্গে এতক্ষণ ধরে কোনো কথা প্রিন্সিপাল তো সে বলেনও নি যে এর জন্য আমি দুঃখিত বা চেষ্টা করছি দেখি বিটি কি করা যায়। কোনো আজ পর্যন্ত কেউ আমাদের সঙ্গে কলেজ থেকে এখনো যোগাযোগ করে।
While the CBI sources say civic volunteer Sanjoy Roy was the man behind the rape and murder, the agency is investigating if there is any wider conspiracy. With Nabila Jamal, Suryagni Roy, Indrajit Kundu, in Kolkata, Bureau Report, India Today.
All right. Now, if I could take our viewers through exactly who are those people who are going to be going through a polygraph test. Of course, Sanjay Roy, we're looking at the RGCAR ex-principal Sandeep Ghosh, who will be going through this polygraph test. But apart from that, four other people working at this very hospital will be going through the polygraph test. If I could mention here, Sandeep Ghosh, of course, apart from that, two first-year PGT students, the post-graduation students, first year, two of them. We understand their fingerprints have been found in the same seminar hall right here where the girl was raped and murdered. Two doctors, first-year doctors, are also going through this polygraph test. A house staff, one house staff, who's also been grilled by the CBI, will be going through this test because this is a house staff who's seen in the CCTV footage walking towards the third floor, towards the seminar hall on the night of the rape and murder. And the fourth one is another intern who spoke to that victim. Basically, she was interacting with the victim right before she went to sleep at the seminar hall. So the last person to have seen Abhaya alive is this intern who's been called in by the CBI. They've been grilled. When I say grilled, they've been questioned. Of course, I'm not too sure if they're being looked at as suspects. But the fact that they're going to go through a polygraph test itself suggests that the CBI just wants to cross-check and verify if there are any inconsistencies in their statements. These are the four people who worked here at RGCAR and knew the girl very well.